Welcome. Let's talk about how to create a marketing segment. You can create a segment in a few places. But wherever you begin, you start with the same setup screen. To build a segment manually, let's use the Visual Builder and create a standard segment. Select Batch Segment and then give the segment a descriptive internal name. When using Marketing Cloud Growth, you must use these selections. Data space equals default, and segment on equals a unified individual object. Keep in mind that your org may have a unique name for unified objects. Now, decide how far back the data in your segment needs to go. If you need only very recent data for your segment, select Rapid Publish. For example, if you're targeting only new leads, you may not need years' worth of engagement data. But in most cases, standard publish is sufficient. Next, choose how often to get new data in your segment. To create a static segment that doesn't change, select Don't Refresh. You can decide to refresh the segment manually later, or before you use it in an active flow. Otherwise, select either 12 or 24 hours, depending on how often you plan to use the segment. Also, decide how long to keep refreshing the segment. And then, save your choices. Next, on the segment Canvas, you can choose attribute filters and configure them. The attribute library contains the available objects and fields that you use to filter your segment. Direct attributes are the fields that appear on the object that you selected to segment on. When you segment on the unified individual, the direct attributes are system fields and other details about a unified profile, such as a first or last name. Related attributes are available fields on other connected objects that have a one-to-many relationship with the object you're segmenting on. For example, email engagement and account are related attributes. Use the buttons to go back or return to the beginning. Click the three dots icon to show your position in the data model. Let's add a rule that looks for leads who are related to accounts with business addresses in the United States.
In the related attributes list, from account, let's choose billing address.
We click country and drag it into the main canvas area. The container path indicates where in your data model the field is pulled from. It defaults to the shortest path, and you usually can leave it as is, unless you store specific data in certain fields and need to specify a particular relationship. The next section contains aggregation details, which you can use to limit your results. To look for individual matching entries, set these fields to count is at least one. Now to the rule field itself. Select an operator and enter a value. Values must be exact, and casing matters. We recommend opening a record where you can copy and paste the value you want. After you enter the text, select a value from the dropdown. Let's drag a new field over. To pull records that match both attributes, use AND. To match either attribute, use OR. Let's set this to AND so we can find recently updated leads in the US. Make sure to save your work. To learn more, check out these resources or join us on the trail at trailblazer.salesforce.com.